9 months ago I started this YouTube channel. Not even 3 months later, I already reached 1,000 subscribers. Now, just a couple of days ago, I finally reached another big milestone. 10,000 subscribers. That is so awesome. Guten Tag everybody, I'm Stefan and welcome to CNC Kitchen. I just looked it up and found out that I actually joined YouTube 11 years ago, and until the beginning of this year, I actually was only a passive viewer. I have already been playing with the idea of making my own videos for quite a while, but did actually not really have the guts and the gear to do them properly. I wasn't really sure what to expect at first, and I guess if my first video would have flopped, I don't know if I would have continued. But now, 9 months later, I have already gathered a crowd of people around me, which is almost half the number of people which live in my hometown. This is amazing, and everything thanks to you out there. Thank you so much! Well, it's kind of sad, but since 100,000 subscribers is still a far way to go, I made myself another YouTube play button. My 1,000 subscribers reward was a wooden play button, the 100,000 subscribers play button will be silver, so I thought copper would be the way to go. If you stick with me today, then I'll show you three cool things. First, how you can copper plate your 3D prints. Second, how you can add a patina on any copper part. And third, how you can use your 3D printer to create high contrast prints on paper. But before I start with that, I would like to thank you with a small giveaway. The guys from Form Futura, who already helped me with my previous 3D printed coffee maker video, were so kind to provide 3 rolls of their Reform filament series, one for each of the lucky winners. The materials from the Reform series are all recycled and upcycled filaments, which are made from residual extrusion waste but still retain the same properties as the standard filaments. If you'd like to win one of these materials, then follow the link below. There are some things happening on the channel. I would like to release more videos, but the whole process just takes so much time for me that I'm currently not able to release one video a week. During my holiday, I finally finished my impact testing machine, which I will be using to continue my technical filament reviews soon. I also got a new 5.5 watt diode laser, which I will need to assemble and make some cool things with it. So stay tuned for that and even more. So in order to make my play button reward, I had to do 3 things. Design and print a play button, which then I had to copy plate, figure out a way to dual color print on a piece of cardboard, and then build a simple frame to hold everything. Since I already designed a play button for my 1000 subscriber special, where I CNC'd it from wood, I used the existing model and printed it in regular PLA on my Prusa. I used the layer height of only 0.05 mm to reduce the staircase effect as much as possible. The print takes longer that way, but it will save me a lot of time during the sanding process. I printed it on its back, which is not ideal for getting a smooth top layer. I did consider printing it in 2 halves and then gluing it together, but this would have required a ton of sanding to get the interface totally smooth. After the print was finished, I sprayed the part a couple of times with filler and then wet sanded it until I was happy with the result. Then comes the electroplating process, which I had already been researching for quite a while. The reason why I didn't just print it in a copper-filled material was that you cannot polish them to a perfect shine, and this was what I was going for at first. In order to electroplate a part, it needs to be conductive. In the best case, you would spray it with silver lacquer. Since I did not have any silver paint, I tried some other things. Graphite spray didn't work unfortunately, so I tried zinc spray, which is usually used for corrosion protection. The interesting thing was that the coating wasn't conductive at first, but as soon as I dipped it into the copper electrolyte, it created a copper coating even without the electricity hooked up. This conductive layer can then be used to proceed with the normal electroplating process. You can buy a copper electrolyte or you can easily make it on your own. For half a liter, I used 410 milliliters of distilled water and added 90 milliliters of battery acid, which actually is 37% sulfuric acid. Then I added 100 grams of blue copper sulfate and a pinch of regular salt. This recipe would already work, but it would produce big copper crystals which would scatter the light and therefore cause a matte surface finish. That's why I added a brightening agent. This will result in only very tiny copper crystals forming on the part, so you will be getting a shiny surface right out of the bath. If you do this on your own, then please wear proper safety equipment and do not discard the copper sulfate solution in the sink because it's very toxic to microorganisms. Before coating the play button with sink spray, I added a piece of wire to the back that I can use to connect the part to my bench power supply. I used a sheet of copper as an electrolyte in the bath, which I connected to the positive pole of my bench power supply. The part gets connected to the negative side. Now it's actually very important to set the voltage and current properly. For copper plating, you usually use 2 to 5 amps of current per square decimeter of surface to plate, which should result in a voltage of less than 2 volts. It's quite important that you make sure that the voltage does not get too high, because if hydrogen bubbles form on your part, it would ruin the surface finish. A thin coat of copper is formed quite quickly. Just make sure that you move your part from time to time to get rid of any bubbles. The longer you will keep it in the electrolyte, the thicker the copper layer will become. I left it in the blue solution for roughly an hour, which left me with a coating which I thought was thick enough for polishing. Unfortunately, the play button did not get perfect and still showed some matte parts on the lower side. I guess that at this location some bubbles gathered and therefore ruined the surface finish. I took the part out of the bath, rinsed it and used some very fine sandpaper to smoothen the rough areas and then started polishing it. Unfortunately, I think I was a little too thorough during the process and the material got too warm. So the copper film started to release in some areas, which was very unfortunate. Well, if you don't look too closely, then you probably don't even notice it. So that's done. This technique can actually not only be used for a nice look, it can also serve a technical purpose. You can use this to 3D print complex antennas or sheet your sensitive electronics. You can even use this to strengthen and stiffen your part because the copper is around 50 times stiffer than the usual plastics, so even a thin layer will make your part way stronger. Since I actually made two play buttons, I created a blue patina on one of the two. The process is pretty simple and works with any copper part, actually even with copper-filled 3D prints. You just put the part on a napkin into a box with a lid. Then you spray it with ammonia solution and sprinkle some table salt over it. After a couple of hours, you'll get a beautiful patina on your part. So what do you think? Shall I rather use my screwed up polish play button or the one with the patina? Next, I had to create the text which goes below the play button. Since regular inkjet and laser printers cannot print white and I didn't want to make myself a silk screen, I decided to try out printing on a piece of paper with my 3D printer. I created the text and the YouTube logo in CAD and saved everything as an STL. Since the logo has a red background, I actually had to save it as two parts because the play button needs to be printed with a different filament. I created two G-code files in Slicer and made sure that I used high C lifts so that the nozzle does not crash into any existing letters. I added a C offset to compensate for the thickness of the cardboard and reduced the speeds quite a bit to get a smooth print. Since mesh bed leveling would be affected by the cardboard, I removed that command from my start script and manually started the process before the print when there was still no paper applied. I taped the cardboard to the print bed of my Prusa and started with printing the red logo, switched the filament to white and printed the rest. I'm not 100% satisfied with the result because due to my really uneven print bed, which can't even be properly compensated with mesh bed leveling, some letters are really squished out. The frame is just made from some 20x20mm wood bar, which I glued together and painted with some black spray paint. I added a small stud with a thread on the back of my play button, screwed everything together, and here we go! My 10,000 subscribers copper play button. Thanks again to everyone who subscribed and supported me along the way. If you haven't subscribed yet, then please do and don't miss any upcoming videos and projects. Hit the like button if you enjoyed the video, that really helps a lot. Thanks for watching, auf Wiedersehen and I'll see you next time.